Good morning, everybody. My presentation is about time perspective in amnesic mild cognitive impairment. A great deal of attention has been paid to the group of patients that are in the boundary between normal aging and dementia, a condition usually called mild cognitive impairment. The MCI patients perform normal activities and daily living and present normal general cognitive function, yet when evaluated, MCI patients show abnormal memory function beyond the expected for age and education. Studies on duration, that is how long an event lasts, and succession, meaning the order or the sequential occurrence of events, have been conducted in patients with AMCI. Perspective referring to our impressions, thoughts, and actions has been not studied yet in patients with MCI. Thus, time perspective has been evaluated using diverse instruments. Zimbardo time perspective inventory measures the beliefs, the thoughts, and the hedonic values one has towards the past, present, and future. Time orientation measures the preference towards a particular time period, and time relation, the perceived relationships among time periods. These instruments have the advantages to assess the free time periods and to evaluate multiple dimensions of time perspective at the same time. Researchers have been proposed a closed link between time perspective and higher cognitive functions. A previous study showed that participants reported everyday faster passers of time displayed a stronger future perspective. Other research has shown that MCI patients reporting time passing slower when producing subjective passage of time judgments compared to healthy controls. In this study, we sought to draw from the multidimensional conceptualization of time. Drawing from the extant literature, we expect that patients with AMCI, by virtue of their illness, may differ in time perspective from healthy controls. We hypothesize that patients with AMCI might show a B's individual preference towards the past in time orientation scale. We hypothesize that patients with a mild cognitive impairment would perceive the relationships among past, present, and future different from their healthy age peers. Lastly, we expect that Zimbardo time perspective inventory would also indicate difference between patients with MCI and healthy adults. 30 MCI patients and 33 controls were submitted to a neuropsychological evaluation and to a time perspective assessment, namely time orientation and relations scales and Zimbardo time perspective inventory. Inclusion criteria for MCI group was presence of memory complaints, abnormal memory function beyond the expected for age and education, normal general cognitive function. Inclusion criteria for control group were no presence of memory complaints, abnormal memory function, normal general cognitive function. Inclusion criteria for both groups were native Portuguese speakers, a level of education of equal or above 4 years and age equal or above 50 years. Exclusion criteria for all groups were dementia, the presence of major depression, neurological disorders, psychiatric conditions, or uncontrolled medical illness, psychoactive medications with possible interference of cognition and time perception, a history of alcohol and drug abuse, a systematic illness with several impacts. Results show that MCI group had a worse cognitive performance namely in memory and executive functions tests, have more memory complaints and more depressing symptoms. No difference emerged between MCI group and control group in demographic variables, in satisfaction with life scale, and in digit span, and in the clock drawing tests. Regarding time orientation scale, participants have to choose among seven configurations. Each configuration has three circles describing the past, the present, or future. The degree of importance of each time dimension was ascribed to the size of the circle. So larger circles represent a large importance. No difference emerged between MCI group and control group. However, results regarding time relation were different. Participants have to choose among five configurations. Each configuration represents the relationships between past, present, and future. Results reveal that MCI group tend to choose configuration one, meaning the unrelated configuration. We tried to see if there was a relationship between this choice and the cognitive profile of participants. So, regarding relation performance, a significant correlation emerged between time trial making test B and digit span backward in MCI group, meaning that the better was the performance of MCI patients, the more related configuration they tend to choose. Regarding Zimbardo time perspective inventory, no difference emerged between the two groups. And the choices fall down in past positive and future. So our conclusions is that patients with MCI tend to perceive the three temporal dimensions as unrelated. This difference was correlated with deficits in executive functions. Contrary to our initial hypothesis, patients with MCI did not show a BIS individual preference towards the past. This certainly reflects that complex emotion personality factors are involved in subjective passage of time judgment. Regarding Zimbardo time perspective inventory, patients with MCI did not differ from health elders in their attitudes towards the past, present, and future. The propensity to connect time dimensions appears to correspond to a healthy partner. The fact that these measures of executive functions correlate significantly with time relation choice reinforces the importance of these cognitive abilities for the completion of this task.